God is a good God.
Yes, he is.
And he's worthy to be praised.
Yes,
even on a bad day, he's a good God.
Yes, he is.
I even found out that he's a man with poor change. He can unbreak your heart. He can lift up that bowed down hand. He'll make the witch and the wicked devil that's taunting you back away from you, leave you alone. I'm talking about Jesus Christ. Come on and praise him.
Scripture saying, thou shalt not muzzle the ox that treadeth out the corn, and the labor is worthy of his reward. And all the Lord is worthy of his reward.
Thank you.
just want to run that by you.
Yes.
If you didn't know, the whole truth just got in Christ.
Yes. Hallelujah.
At this time, we're going to move forward in our service and just call for offering. We're going to have our own divorce.
Right here. we do give honor to the end. As I said, we're gonna raise an offering. So let's prepare our hearts. Give me some good music.
Thank you.
what he's doing. I Father in Jesus' name, God, we lift this offering, lift the gift and give it. Father, that you would bless this offering. Bless it, multiply it, use it for the
love you got. We all got it now.
Let's give and give it. Then some 30, some 60, then God, even 100-fold. And if nobody thank you, then we thank you. We give you the glory and we count it down even now. In Jesus' name, amen.
I don't know what I got, but I got it. Sweet something.
Superintendent Urban.
saved Nancy Grace. She's the saved Nancy Grace. That's what we call her.
Yes, district missionary. Oh, district. Hell yeah. She was sitting in the back. She said, I just wanted to see what God was doing. And I thank God for her. And I pray that God will continue to bless our district. Yeah. We're a district there. It says, old man, Martha. And we're trying to preserve that old man, Martha. That's that old man, Martha. Right. So that God will make, please. And I think I've only been in this jurisdiction for 1 or 4 months, but I think I have the greatest mission in the world. When he was working with Bishop Blakely, I remember him.
Uh-huh.
And
yeah.
He is always good. Even cheap.
Yeah.
I like that of him. And I'm grateful to be up under him and to have one of this caliber is alive. And I thank God for him. And we're going to continue to be obedient to him, to lift him up, and to do the things that God would have us to do. Because we want him to be around for a long time. Servanthood over at True Life Church. And I just want to say I thank God for Bishop Henry Martin.
God can be praised. He's a great man of God. He's a prophet that wants to see the move of God. He told me when he first met me, he said, I'm going to let you know right now, I don't play. And my wife said, now, that's what we're looking for, Bishop. Somebody that's serious about the work of the Lord. Let's say that for the choir as they come back to us.
Thank you.
bowled out. Yeah. Yeah. We're going to have a long ride. We're going to run on and see what the end is. Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you. God knew that I would be here today. Some 64 years ago, God knew that I would be a bishop. So, he wanted me to qualify. So, he looked down to here in Gary, Indiana. Saw a one-man woman. Oh, so you were going to be a one-woman man. He knew I was going to be a bishop. Well, a bishop must be the husband of what? At least one at a time.
Thank you.
I am weak. I
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You got to move.
I need to be my family.
I thank God for the pastors. I bought the pastors a gift.
hopefully they'll be useful in your local churches. I thank God for the missionaries and the sisters. The mothers of fire, we couldn't have a church without the sisters. The only thing I can do with the brothers is go fishing, go hunting. Yeah, come church there. I like that. That's a soprano voice I like to hear. That helps me to serve the Lord with gratitude and come before His presence with singing. Hallelujah. And has anything else ever forget the saints of the Most High God? That brother and sister who God hasn't led to be a deacon, a missionary, and they are just brother or sister. Grandmother would say baking powder. Orange juice. It makes no difference. God loves you too. And I'm here to tell you, we preachers, we pastors could not live, exist without you, just the ordinary saint of God. And I bless God for you. My Uncle John Hall, I don't know if y'all remember him. He used to sing a song. There's a lot of things that go down. We don't always understand everything. But he sang a song we'll understand it better.
I'm done.
Say that to yourself. I'll understand it better.
I'll understand it better.
By and by.
Amen.
There's a lot of things that happen before us, our very eyes, right when we are witness to it. We may not understand what's happening. But later, we can look back and check everything out and we'll understand it. Hallelujah. Hope you'll receive that. I have a message that I must deliver. It's a simple message. The pastor. Can you say that with me? The pastor. I need to have some readers. Alessandra, can you read with me?
Yes, sir.
Let's go to Jeremiah 3:13-15. Everybody have their sword. Anytime you go to the house of God, you need your sword. You don't know when you may have to fight a battle.
Right.